a new way of, I think, for the audience. My background is absolutely classical. I three university degree in piano and organ, but absolutely classical. But in my family, when I was a child, I remember my father with passion for jazz music, my mother with, of course, passion for the classical music, and my brother, the passion with the progressive rock music. So I had inside me the passion for all the music, so like an open mind. I don't like only the classical music. I think, for example, Duke Ellington, that say the music is good or bad. So I think we have some masterpieces also in the jazz music and the rock, same as rock and jazz music. So the first time that I tried to play this music was for a special occasion, for invitation from a festival in Chelyabinsk in the Russian-Europe part. Dedicated to jazz and rock pipe organ music. It was very, very, very interesting. And I started to transcribe some music from British rock band. Practically all the progressive music is born in England. And all the musicians from progressive music are background of classical and jazz music. The progressive music practically joins the rock music with jazz, with blues, and with classical music all together. It's very particular effect. And I tried to transcribe some pieces, but it was very difficult because we don't take the original score. So practically, I transcribed the music. Mm-hmm. And after the transcriptions, I made the arrangement for the, in this case, for the organ or for the piano. And today I want to show shortly three pieces from the three most, I think, important progressive musicians. The first is Rick Wakeman. Rick Wakeman, of course, in England, is very famous. And was the original keyboard player of the progressive band, Yes. The first solo album by Rick Wakeman is named The Sixth Wife of Henry VIII. So six pieces, every piece is dedicated to one wife. I want to play now Jane Seymour, that is original piece for pipe organ and drums, bass, and some organ Hammond. Practically, this is my transcription of Jane Seymour for solo.
Thank you.
classical music, because Wakeman take inspiration in this case from Bach, the fugue of Toccata, the fugue D minor, but like a mirror at contrary, and the Toccata style of Domenico Scarlatti, and Wakeman is very, very close to classical Baroque style, also with the composition of the jazz. The second musician that I want to show shortly is Steve Hackett. Steve Hackett was the former guitarist of the Genesis band, and also the background of Steve Hackett is classical, because Steve wrote solo pieces for classical guitar in classical style, and pieces for electric guitar in blues and rock style. This transcription is from the first album of Steve from 1975. The name of this piece is The Elms of the Priestess. The original piece is from classical guitar, flute and keyboards. And this is transcription for some organ. And the flute part normally was played from John Hackett, that is brother, that joined me this evening for the concert to play one piece together.
Thank you.
case the style is more closer to impressionism, you will see also English music like Robin Williams or Peter Ward. The last piece I want to show today is from another very famous keyboard pianist, Keith Emerson, from Emerson, Lake and Palmer. All the music, or maybe 90% of the music, Keith Emerson, is take inspiration from original classical music with variations. For example, it's very famous, the piece on Mussorgsky, the tableau de l'exposition. In this case, I will play one fantasy on a fanfare for the common man by Aaron Copland. The first part is a variation of fanfare for the common man. The middle part of the piece is a jazz improvisation on fanfare for the common man. The third part, the main theme, come back like the opening theme. So this is the original piece is for organ Hammond, mini Moog, this is a special keyboard instrument, drums, and bass.
Thank you.
especially reminiscent of Apparition de l'Église.